Hey guys, I'm currently at the hospital for Shaden. He has a full day of scans. He's currently in his MRI. I thought this would be the perfect time to hurry up and get a pregnancy vlog recorded. Trying to find a quiet place to record is the best I can do. Unfortunately, I don't have my tripod or anything, so we're just gonna do it in the quiet corner of the waiting room. I have quite a few notes here of what I wanna talk about with you guys today. So today I'm gonna be doing a 36 and 37 week pregnancy vlog. I probably won't be talking too loud because, like I said, I'm in a waiting room and I don't want to disturb other people. So I know I'm super duper behind in these vlogs. I was trying so hard to make sure that I like got caught up with them, and just life just keeps getting in the way for me. In the last, like, between weeks 33 and 35 were super hard for me because I was like just starting my infusions. I was so tired and the fatigue was literally like running my life. Basically all I did was sleep and go to the bathroom. So not too much happened, I feel like, in those weeks. So I want to just hurry up and get this vlog out. I just turned 37 weeks, so I want to talk about weeks 36 and 37 since I was kind of doing combo vlogs anyway. That way I can at least be caught up. I won't be like weeks and weeks behind and then I have the baby, and I'm really determined to just finish this and see this through. So with that being said, let's just jump right into it. Last week I started back to work, as well as the kids have officially started back to school. Because of that, there is just so much driving involved. It is crazy. I spend so much of my time driving. We don't all go to the same place. Lyric and Zuka are going to be starting preschool this year. I'm so excited and also kind of sad about that. But they don't start until actually next week. So because of that, they're going to a babysitter, the same babysitter that watched them last year. She's a friend of mine and she lives all the way in a different part of the city. So basically I have to drive to one city to drop off Lyric and Zuko to the babysitter. Then I have to drive all the way back to a different city, which is where Shaden is currently going to school. And then I have to drive to where my work is. And Parker is going to school with me this year in my school. It is a school of choice, and unfortunately Shaden has not quite made the list yet. There is still a possibility, because we are still in like the first week of school, that he will be able to, like, if someone decides to move, that he'll be bumped up to the list, because he's literally like the next person on the list. So I'm still like crossing my fingers that happens, but right now Parker and Shaden are going to two different schools in two different cities, so I have to drive to three different cities in order to drop everybody off where they need to be dropped off. So it is just a lot of driving, and then I have to drive to those three places to pick them all up, and basically I spend most of my day driving, and it's just a lot, and it makes my body feel stiff and swollen, and it just is, it's just not ideal. It's not convenient and it's just not fun. Feet and hands, like I said, are swollen, especially after I'm doing all that driving, but I have been experiencing a lot of swelling in my arms and my joints and my feet. I'm currently swollen right now. My hands are doing okay, but my feet are swollen because I'm here at the hospital, and the hospital is a really long drive away, and I've been doing a lot of walking. I already have swollen feet right this second. It's just a very uncomfortable feeling, but especially at night, I always wake up like swollen everywhere. My hands, my feet, my arms, my legs, my ankles, my face. I always wake up really swollen. I usually take a shower in the morning to try and wake myself up a little bit. That usually helps bring down some of the swelling a little bit. But yeah, I wake up like that every morning. I also always wake up every morning, or even not just in the morning, but like when I get up to go to the bathroom, with dead arms. What I mean by that is like I've lost circulation like in my arms or my hands. It like takes me a while to like get feeling and circulation back into my fingers. I don't know if it's a spinal alignment thing. Unfortunately, it's not possible for different reasons for me to go see a chiropractor right now. I know people will probably suggest that that is something that I've considered and thought about, but long story short, I'm not able to see a chiropractor at this moment in time, but I wake up that way like every time I go to sleep. And I'm waking up a lot, not only because I'm going pee at this point in my pregnancy all the time. I wake up at least 3 to 5 times a night to go pee because baby's like kicking my bladder, but also because my pelvis is so broken. Okay, it's not really broken, but it feels like it's broken and it feels like it's falling apart. I'm in like constant pain, like 24/7. Sleeping is the worst because I can only sleep on my sides. So I only have two positions I can sleep in, and my hips are burning just even like they constantly burn. My pelvis feels like it's broken. And then when I get up to go to the bathroom, it feels like I'm going to just fall apart. And it's so hard to walk. I'm in so much pain. I also think that baby has dropped finally. I don't know if I've talked about this in my last vlog or not, but baby was sitting like transverse and really high up for like the longest time. It was kind of like frustrating me a little bit actually, because I'm like, I do not want a transverse baby. I want this baby to be head down so that I don't have to worry about like which way I'm gonna deliver, at least in that aspect. I think baby's finally dropped in my pelvis, definitely head down, at least at my last appointment the baby was. But speaking of my last appointment, it didn't actually go that well. I'm kind of a bundle of nerves about it, trying not to be super stressed out about it, but it's giving me serious deja vu of how my last pregnancy went. Long story short, I went for my regular 36-week appointment. Pretty standard appointments usually last about 15 minutes, where they weigh you, they get your blood pressure, they get your temperature, they measure your stomach, the fundal height, and then they listen to the heartbeat. If you have any questions, that's the time to ask, and then you're done. It takes all of like 15-20 minutes. But at my last appointment, when they measured me, she measured me first. I was measuring over 40 weeks just based on fundal height. And I have been feeling like this whole pregnancy, I've been measuring so huge. I was like that with Zuko as well. I thought Zuko was gonna come out like a ginormous baby because I was measuring so big. He ended up being one of my smallest. So I had 2 8-pounders. Parker and Shaden were both 8 pounds. Parker was 8'10", Shaden was 8'11". Lyric came out 7'14", which really surprised me because I thought, or at least I'd been told, that each subsequent baby was gonna get bigger and bigger. And Zuko came out wearing the exact same amount. He was also 7 pounds, 14 ounces. So obviously that whole thing didn't ring true, but at the same time, I thought he was gonna be huge. And that's not to say that I still can't have like a giant baby. I've proven that I can carry 8-pound babies to term, and they weren't like little 8-pounders. They were 8 pounds, 10 ounces. So like almost 9. And my little body, you know, carried those and birthed those. That's not to say that it couldn't happen. So I am worried about how big the baby is measuring. And also when they were trying to listen to the baby's heart rate, the doctor said that she was hearing decelerations. I had Lyric and Zuko with me at the appointment, and she's like, I know that you have, you know, your kids in tow, but I really don't feel comfortable sending you home without an NST, which is basically where they strap you up to the monitors and they keep track of your contractions and the baby's heart rate. I've gotten several of them before. Luckily, I was able to call Cody so that he could pick them up at the clinic so that they wouldn't have to sit with me, because usually the NSTs take about an hour. So the heart rate was having a few decelerations during the NST, so they sent me over to the ultrasound. I got an ultrasound not only to check on the baby's heart and stuff and get measurements, but also that they could see what the measurements were for growth. Unfortunately, I didn't get any of that information at that appointment because this was a little bit unexpected, and I already had like a later appointment in the day. So by the time I got this NST and this ultrasound and everything, everybody was leaving for the day. The clinic was closing. So I will have to wait for those results at my next appointment, because techs usually aren't allowed to interpret the readings of the ultrasound. A doctor has to do that. But I do know for sure she said that the baby was measuring large. I don't know what the exact like measurements were, but that the measurements were large. And also I was diagnosed with polyhydramnios, which basically means I have an excess amount of fluid. And I had the same exact stuff happen right before Zuko was born. He had the decelerations, he had the slowed down movement, I had the ultrasound, I was diagnosed with polyhydramnios. It's almost happening like almost in the exact same way. So as you could probably, you know, understand, it just makes me feel a little bit stressed out because I don't want a repeat of Zuko's birth. It was traumatic, it was scary. I mean, it took me a long time to get over not only how his labor and delivery went, but then all the time he spent in NICU and how scared I was the whole time, not knowing what was gonna happen to him. Because when he first went into NICU, he was very, very sick. It's just stressful. I just don't want anything else to happen medically with my children. I just don't think I could take the stress. But as far as everything else, I actually am feeling more prepared for baby to come. I was feeling pretty not prepared at all, like just a couple weeks ago, but I'm starting to like gather items. I've gotten pretty much everything for baby, like secondhand or free. I don't have a lot of new stuff, but that's okay with me. I don't mind having secondhand. I've gotten a lot of stuff either from friends or family or people just giving stuff away. There's been a couple items that I've gotten off the side of the road, which sounds really sketchy and ghetto, but I promise, like, these things are in really good condition. I live in a really nice neighborhood, and sometimes these people give away stuff that's like, it's just more convenient for them to get rid of it rather than having to spend the energy of trying to sell it or something. So a lot of times I'll get stuff for free that's in really good condition. I don't know everything that I have so far. I'm pretty sure I'm set on clothes for the most part. I have a pack and play with a bassinet. I have a car seat. I have a play mat. So I'm feeling a little bit more comfortable and a little bit more prepared for baby to come. Like I said, I still need to sort through clothes. There's still a couple things that I need to set up as far as, like I said, the pack and play with the little newborn bassinet. There's a couple things that I'm like delaying doing, including putting in the car seat, because I've only got a few weeks now. And I know a lot of people at this point are putting in the car seat because it could like happen any day. I'd have to rearrange the way all my kids are in their car seats, like in what order they're in. I did get a new car after my last car accident. I don't think I've mentioned that or brought that up. I say new, it's new to me. It's a pre-owned vehicle, but it's new to me. I got a nice brand new minivan, so it's very spacious. I'm so excited about it. And I think the way I'm going to arrange the kids is I'm gonna have the three oldest in the back with Parker in the middle, and then I'll have the two youngest in the captain chairs in the middle row. But I don't wanna do that right now because Lyric can't unbuckle himself. Shaden, even though he's almost seven, he can unbuckle his chest clip, but he can't unbuckle that red button part at the bottom. And right now with my baby bump, I can't reach him to go back there. So I either have to rely on Parker to unbuckle him, or I have to unbuckle him myself. And if Parker's not there, then it's just kind of a tricky situation. So I haven't set up the car seat. That was a really like roundabout way of explaining that, but yeah. And I'm sorry if the lights keep changing. They have like mood lighting going on here in the waiting room, and I feel like it's messing with my camera's like lighting focus thing. So I've gone over quite a bit of information. I think the last couple things I want to talk about is just like how I'm physically feeling. Right now I'm up to 40 pounds. You're supposed to gain between 25 to 35, so I'm not too much over. I'm not super duper concerned about it, especially with how much like fluid I'm apparently carrying. I do freak out a little bit about that number because it is so high for me, but then I have to like think about like, okay, most of it is baby, and like you've only gained 40 pounds. That's really not that much. Like that's about how much I gain, like between 40 to 50 pounds per pregnancy. I've always gained that much, and then I've always pretty much lost it all. So not super duper concerned about it yet. Now if I gain like 20 more pounds in the next week, then I might be a little concerned. Physically, I'm exhausted. My pelvis hurts. It's impossible to walk sometimes. I end every single day on my heating pad with Tylenol. Otherwise, I just simply cannot function the next day, especially with work. There's just a lot of activity I have to do while I'm working, up and down on the floor, lots of activity. And every single day I have to end it on my heating pad with Tylenol, or I just like, I cannot function the next day. I just can't. I've also been experiencing really bad heartburn, usually at night. I don't think I really experience it during the day, but at night it's like really hard to sleep sometimes or fall asleep because I have really bad heartburn and reflux. I've been taking Tums, which I'm pretty sure is like really the only thing you can take for heartburn during pregnancy. And let me tell you, Tums are the worst. Like they taste so gross to me. They make me so nauseous taking them. They don't even really help that much. It's better than taking nothing. I also have a lactose intolerancy, so I can't really like drink milk, is what a lot of people suggest. They're like, drink milk and it'll help. And I'm like, I can't. It makes my tummy upset. That's kind of like where I'm at. I did confirm at my last ultrasound the baby has a lot of hair, so at least the heartburn is paying off towards something. This is gonna be a little bit TMI, but I've had a really big issue with hemorrhoids this pregnancy. I've had issues with hemorrhoids, I should say, every pregnancy, but I just feel like really badly this pregnancy. I got them with Parker, and with each subsequent pregnancy, they've gotten worse and worse and worse. If you remember correctly, I got a thrombosed hemorrhoid right before I delivered Zuko. I ended up having to get a procedure where it like was cut open and drained, and it was a horrible, horrible experience. And then I went into labor with him like right after that. I've had to deal with that again this pregnancy. I just had like an ongoing issue with them. It sucks. It's one of the darker sides of pregnancy that nobody really talks about, but if you suffer from them, like I feel you, I understand, I relate. They are a taboo topic that nobody talks about, and it sucks. They suck. I also had a question from one of my viewers. Okay, this question is from Amy Briggs, and I've gotten this question a couple times. I apologize, Amy. A lot of times by the time I upload a video, I've already had like pre-recorded videos and they're just late. So a lot of times when you're commenting, it's not like in real-time video footage. I don't know how else to explain that, but I did promise that I would answer her question in the next video. And basically she asked me, have you had any embarrassing or TMI symptoms like lots of gas, farting, during your pregnancy? This is kind of a weird question, not gonna lie, Amy. I'm still trying to decide if you're trolling me or not. I'm usually pretty open with my symptoms though, so I'm gonna go ahead and give you the benefit of the doubt. I'm gonna say, yes, I've had embarrassing symptoms. Gas and farting is not one of them. I mean, everybody has gas, but I haven't had it to like an excessive amount. But TMI symptoms, I mean, like I just got done talking about hemorrhoids, so, you know, there's that. Can I think of anything else that's been like TMI or embarrassing? As far as like that specific symptom, not really. I tend to stay away from foods that make me super gassy, like milk tends to do. Broccoli, ironically, does. I don't know if anybody else does, but broccoli does. You can also get like Beano for that though. Like what's that phrase that they do? Like, take Beano before, there'll be no gas or something like that. So yeah, as far as that specific symptom, it hasn't been to an excessive amount, just like what your normal human body does. But anything else TMI or embarrassing related, like if it happens, I usually am pretty forward about it. Hopefully that answered your question. I think that's all I want to talk about in this video. I feel like I've been talking for a really long time at this point, so I'm gonna go ahead and end it here. If you guys have any other questions that you guys would like me to answer, go ahead and leave it in the comment section down below. If you guys like this video, which hopefully you did, make sure you guys give it a big thumbs up. It really helps my channel, it really helps my algorithm. Just give it a big thumbs up so that it makes me feel better about my life. No, I'm just kidding. Also, make sure that you guys are subscribed if you aren't already so that you never miss an update from me, and I will see you guys in the next video. Okay, bye guys. Guys.